In my view, the math practices are really all that matter. Content is content, and we've seen them in many forms. If we can do something about the math practices, then we stand a chance of really changing mathematics education. Now, as you know, there are 8 of them. This should be done in all grade levels, and we need to find a way of remembering them. And so what I did is put together some icons that may help you remember each of the 8 math practices. The first one is about problem solving. And the key thing here is how do we present problems and does it make sense? So the first thing I worry about is what is the problem you do? And I love this slide because the hint is make a table, and the kid says, I didn't even have to do that. The other thing about making sense, folks, is raining cats and dogs. That makes sense. So we look at that. Reasoning abstractly, quantitatively. I think this decontextualized, contextualized thing is extremely important to work with our students. So I came up with a problem for you to remember to do this. Contextualized, it has to do with a clock and time. Decontextualized, you take the numbers and add them up. But 70 has to be regrouped with 60 minutes for hours. So we have to go back and contextualize. That's what that's about. The math practices number 3 is about viable arguments. How do we deal with that? And there are 2 components. One is critiquing, and the other is counterexamples. Now you're all familiar with this group. We gotta critique it. But we also need to ask students, is there a counterexample to that statement? Is there a counterexample to that statement? Math practices number 3. Modeling is the math practice number 4. And there are many uses of the word model. I picked a couple that I particularly like for the icons. One of them is what happens when we're kids and we make models. But for those of you who'd like a more pleasant view of modeling for practice 4, just keep it in mind, you never know. Using appropriate tools strategically. We need to figure out what tools are there, and you notice I changed it to GSP and FAP, and it's in there. I know who's paying for this. Okay. And there are the math tools that we use, but we as teachers need to know that there are other tools that we use to teach mathematics. So there's a couple of icons to keep in your mind. The next one is precision, and this one really drives me nuts. My grandniece uses a graphing calculator for everything, to 4 decimal places. Whether we're going to the moon or doing the circumference of a table, we do it to 4 decimal places. That's what you get in Excel. Precision. What does it have to do? But there's another aspect of precision. If you want to weigh that little turtle, which scale do you use? Something that we often don't think about. The heart of mathematics for me is structure. And I decided that, okay, for this one I was going to be real mathematical. And so you can see the next slide, which will come up in a minute. There's the structure for multiplication, whether it's a 2-digit number or binomials, we have structure. And we want our students to see that and know that that's what mathematics is about. Our last practice has to do with regularity. And it's something that does occur in mathematics, and I think the basic one that we all think about when we think about regularity is the slope. They help me remember what everything says. And so I shared those with you as a way of remembering what's going on. But we do need to go on. By the way, if pi were equal to 3, that's what you would get. The practices are the most important part of the Common Core. We need to use them in order to improve math education.